Hello, I'm Thais Libardoni, a master's student of Federal University of Pelotas, Brazil. First of all, I'd like to thank you for this opportunity to share knowledge. Today I'm going to give you a short presentation on active aging in urban sustainability. It's a part of my research with a special focus on older women. My supervisor is Professor Ligia Chiarelli. The current global scenario shows the population aging in the feminization of old age. In developing countries like Brazil, the phenomenon is more recent and fast than what happens in developed countries. The search for concepts on the aging process started in the 60s. From then on, we can observe an evolution of the concept. The successful aging was basically about prevent physical losses. In the early 21st century, the active aging concept started to be used. The concept deals with the active participation of the elderly, including in the social environment. In the year 2007, the Global Guide for Age-Friendly Cities was drawn up, bringing the concept of active aging closer to town planning. The lack of social relationships is as harmful to health as smoking, high blood pressure, obesity, and sedentary lifestyle. Social interaction happens on many levels and it depends on environmental setting. So, urban public spaces can help in these relations, being attractive and supportive, but they can also segregate certain users, especially those most vulnerable. Elderly women are more vulnerable in situations of insecurity. In some studies, the presence of women and children is an indicator of safety. In addition, due to the values of other times, men have a tradition of socialization in urban public spaces. But women are sometimes restricted to the home environment and controlled socialization situations. The research that originated this study is based on three structuring elements. Urban public spaces, where the meeting and the appropriations of differences happen. So, these spaces need to support the differences. And in the context of the phenomenon of population aging, it is pertinent to talk about intergenerational relations. These relations provide mutual gain among those involved. They reduce ageism by recognizing differences. In the same way, the contact with public spaces is a way to stay socially active, especially for young and older people. Young people, because they need a neutral space to develop physical, social, and psychological skills. And older people because they need to maintain the same skills. Moreover, in 2009, Michael Lane worked with certain perceptive similarities between these two age groups. Then we come to the third element of the research, environmental psychology. The research uses an ecological perspective. Environment and users influence each other. And by Gibson's theory of affordances, there is a kind of user-environment communication. What environment allows will depend on the characteristics and the needs of the user. This study is just a part of my master's research, Urban Public Spaces and Intergenerational Relations, Affordances of Support for Young and Older People in the Historic Center of Pelotas, which analyzes opportunities for intergenerational relations of the elderly and young people. There are some similarities of physical, social, and psychological needs and perceptions among young and older people. So, my hypothesis is, the similarities can produce similar urban appropriations that help in planning attractive places for both age groups. This study deals with gender issues present in these relationships, with the aim of analyzing the appropriation of the elderly woman in public spaces. So, this study takes place in four different typologies of public spaces: Central Square, Urban Park, Largo, and Commercial Pedestrian Street. The specific aims are to map the use of spaces according to age and gender, to analyze the factors that can facilitate or hinder the appropriation by the elderly women. It's a case study because it's about contemporary events without behavior control. And here, we have the location and some information about Pelotas, the Brazilian city where the study takes place. In the map, we can see number 1, Dom Antônio Zátera Park, number 2, Commercial Pedestrian Street, number 3, Coronel Pedro Osório Central Square, and number 4, Largo of the Public Market. Methods of this stage: bibliographical and documentary research, physical survey, and behavioral mapping. We have a total of 12 maps in each area. Some pictures of the Dom Antônio Zátera Park. In the number 1, fitness equipment. In the number 2, the children's school. In the numbers 3 and 5, the skate lane. In the number 4, the playground. In the number 9, the sports court. The commercial pedestrian street. Here you can see some of the benches arranged along the street. In the numbers 3 and 6, the areas that older men like the most. The Coronel Pedro Osório Central Square. In the number 1, the fountain. In the numbers 3 and 7, the lake. In the number 5, the chess tables. In the number 6, the playground. The Largo of the Public Market. It's a kind of plaza in front of the public market building. In this space, there are tables with umbrellas that belong to the restaurants, in a public-private relation. Results and discussion. 9.14% of the city's population are elderly women, and only 6.01% are elderly men, but the frequency of the elderly women in none of the cases is greater than 7.47% that happens in the Largo. In none of the spaces, the presence of older women outnumbers the older men. In the square and in the commercial pedestrian street, the numbers reveal an even more significant difference. In the square, the frequency of elderly women is the lowest of all spaces. Young people show a reverse situation. Girls represent 51.78% of the young public in the square. Only one elderly woman was observed in the playground area. The presence is greater in the esplanade located in front of the Theater 7 de Abril. One of the observation sessions coincided with an antimanicomial manifestation, highlighting its potential to receive various types of programmed events. The Largo is the space of greater presence of elderly women. The space receives several programmed events as fairs and shows that use the potential of space. The greater frequency of elderly women occurs precisely on Saturdays during the events. The commercial pedestrian way on 7 de Setembro Street was identified as an age micro-territory for older people, but it has the lowest female percentage in the elderly group, 24.7%. The space has a tradition of masculine socialization in cafes. The park is the third place in the frequency of elderly women, 6.04%. But it is the one with the highest female proportion of the elderly, 45.17%. The areas most frequented by the elderly are the physical equipment and the one near to Bento Gonçalves Avenue, which attract the older ones to observe the movement and the activities. The areas less frequented by the elderly women are the skate lane and the playground. Conclusions. The study shows the importance of potential areas for programmed and controlled social activities. Women, unlike men, were not socialized in the past in autonomous sociability activities, clearly demonstrating a difference in the treatment of urban social relations between genders. The younger population presents a more balanced gender division, and with feminine predominance in some cases. This way, it is inferred that the use of urban environments by women may be changing. With the passing of the generations, certain traditions and prejudices are changing. However, a longitudinal study is needed to deepen these findings. Safety appears linked not only to the presence of people in the spaces, but also to characteristics such as gender and age. Elderly people seek groups made up of similar ones. Playground areas are seldom frequented by elderly women. Also, the presence of children is one of the factors usually associated with the sense of security. And finally, about gender and appropriation of public spaces. There is evidence that the difficulty of appropriation by the elderly in the public spaces of socialization tends to manifest more strongly in relation to women, not only due to vulnerability and security issues, but also strong issues of gender representation.
Her lips. She's a rock and roll survivor with pendulum hips. She's got deep brown eyes that have seen it all. Working at a nightclub that was called the Avenue, the barman used to call her Little Lisa Looney Tunes. She went down on almost anyone. But from the hard time living till the Chelsea days, from when her hair was sweet blonde till the day it turned gray, she said, L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. Got more than money and sense, my friends. You got heart, and you go in your own way. L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. What you don't have now will come back again. You got heart, and you go in your own way. Like a map on their face. And Joey was an artist just living out a case, but his best word was his letters home. Extended works of fiction about imaginary success, when chorus girls and neon were his closest thing to friends. But to a writer, the truth is no big deal. And from the hard time living to the sleepless nights and the black and blue body from the weekend fights, he'd say, L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. Got more than money and sense, my friend. You got heart, and you go in your own way. L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. What you don't have now will come back again. You got heart, and you go in your own way. Just breathe in the air and blink in the light. My last night on earth, I pay a high price to have no regrets and be done with my life. L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. Got more than money and sense, my friend. You got heart, and you go in your own way. L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. What you don't have now will come back again. You got heart, and you go in your own way. L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. Got more than money and sense, my friend. You got heart, and you go in your own way. L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N. What you don't have now will come back again. You got heart,
likes brandy and the way it hits her lips. She's a rock and roll survivor with pendulum hips. She's got deep brown eyes that have seen it all. Working at a nightclub that was called the Avenue, the barman used to call her Little Lisa Looney Tunes. She went down on almost anyone. But from the hard time living till the Chelsea days, from when her hair was sweet blonde till the day it turned gray, she said,
L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N.
You got more than money and sense, my friend. You got heart and you go in your own way.
L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N.
What you don't have now will come back again. You got heart and you go in your own way. Some people wear the history like a map on their face, and Joey was an artist just living out a case. But his best word was his letters home. Extended works of fiction about imaginary success, when chorus girls and neon were his closest thing to friends. But to a writer, the truth is no big deal. And from the hard time living to the sleepless nights and the black and blue body from the weekend fights, he'd say,
L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N.
Got more than money and sense, my friend. You got heart and you go in your own way.
L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N.
What you don't have now will come back again. You got heart and you go in your own way. On my last night on earth, I won't look to the sky. Just breathe in the air and blink in the light. On my last night on, pay a high price to have no regrets and be done with my life.
L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N.
Got more than money and sense, my friend. You got heart and you go in your own way.
L-I-F-E-G-O-E-S-O-N.
What you don't have now will come back again. You got heart and you go in your own way.